Now it is coming up to 5 to 7, and are you fascinated by tales of the supernatural? If so, you might want to make a date in your diary to head to Stirling this Halloween, when the city will be the venue for the first Scottish Paranormal Festival. Organisers claim it'll be a mixture of serious debate and fun. Our reporter Andrew Anderson braved Stirling's old town to find out more.
Walking through the alleyways of the old town in Stirling, it's not difficult to see why this was once regarded as the most densely populated supernatural square mile in Scotland. Every town and city across Scotland has its fair share of ghost stories and tales of the supernatural. Here in Stirling, they've got the Green Lady and old Stainy Breeks, who, legend has it, every Hogmanay leaps off the tower of Cowan's Hospital and dances with the revellers. And, of course, there's the happy hangman.
Allow me to present myself, Master Jock Rankin, staff man, torturer and executioner to the Royal Borough.
That's David Kinnaird, who's run the Stirling Ghost Walk for a quarter of a century.
Increasingly, I would say, there's a fascination with the supernatural, with folklore, and if I can use that as a way to galvanise interest in history, in heritage and in that folklore, then all well and good.
And it's that kind of interest that's led to plans for a festival of the paranormal in Stirling. In the graveyard of the city's Holyrood Church, film and TV producer Peter Braun explained his idea.
It always seemed to me that Scotland was a place that had a lot going for it in terms of history and myth and legend and stories of the supernatural. It's a very supernatural place, and it seemed a very natural place to locate a festival, because there isn't actually anything very much like this in the rest of the UK or Europe, or indeed throughout the world. There are some UFO festivals in America and so on, but I think we can claim that this is already the biggest paranormal festival in these islands.
And David Kinnaird believes the cobbled streets, alleyways and historic buildings of Stirling's old town are the ideal setting for a festival of the paranormal.
For 25 years now, we've been using the toll booth, Mars Walk, the wonderful Holyrood churchyard. There are stones in there from the 16th century, side by side with great Victorian monuments. You couldn't wish for a better set.
The festival's being described as a mixture of the serious and the light-hearted. Among those due to appear are some of the world's top ufologists, who've studied reports of unidentified flying objects and alien visitations. But alongside them will be appearing the self-proclaimed world's worst psychic. Young filmmakers are being invited to submit short films on a paranormal theme. Peter Braun is confident the festival will tap into a fascination for ghosts and ghouls and all things odd and unexplained.
There's lots of paranormal programming on television. If you go into the internet, you'll find that there are millions of videos on YouTube that on the subject. So I think that we're tapping into a vein of interest that already exists, and I'm sure that people will support it, and I hope we'll have sellout sessions in all parts of the festival.
Peter Braun wants the paranormal festival to make Stirling the top Halloween destination in Scotland. If it succeeds this October, then the ghosts that are said to haunt its back streets may find there's no shortage of folk to put the frighteners on.
Well, it must